Welcome back, and this is what we're going to be making this week. This really cool time lapse where we're going to be tracking a running person. So this is an idea that I've had in my head where you would be following somebody that's running or walking or whatever, but then right by our apartment there is a roundabout, and I thought it'd be fun to see somebody walking across the whole roundabout and then just do the whole thing every season and slowly have the seasons change. So we just shot the first one, and we're gonna kind of break down what goes into it and how it's all done. And my good friend Kelly Roberts, who runs Badass Lady Gang, is deciding to help and be the model. So the first thing that I did was I just basically had to communicate it. And so I downloaded some Google Maps and explained, you know, hey, what I'm looking for you to do is to run down this. Once you get there, just kind of walk across the street. I'm going to get all my stuff and run out there, and we're gonna try to shoot her as she finishes up her run. So let's go.
Okay, so I just got in position. We are here. We got our time lapse going, taking an interval every 1 second. And then what we're gonna have to do is Kelly's gonna be running right through there and then start walking. I got this camera all set up at 1 second interval as well. And basically what I'll be doing is just tracking her all the way through here as we go all the way around this roundabout. And then she's gonna exit stage right. Oh, I think I see her coming, so we're gonna get started.
Okay. And there she goes. She's running. All right, this bus is an issue. Trying to see her through the windows, yep. And off she goes. Oh shit, that is a bit of a problem. That is a huge problem. Oh, damn it, look at that. Oh my God, I don't even know what to do. Look at that right there. Just kind of blocked the last shot. I didn't really think about that. I'm definitely bummed. I don't think we got it. Oh shit, she might have just stayed there. Oh my God, look at that. What a pro. What a pro. Oh my God, she stayed there. So the Duncan's bus really screwed it up, but she's gonna try it again. So we're just starting the time lapse again, and we're gonna let it run for 2 minutes and then we're gonna try it again.
All right, so we're back and the shooting went pretty well. A couple things that I realized I didn't explain so well is, one, I decided to go without motion blur because that way we wouldn't have to worry about zooming in to Kelly, because otherwise her face would be all blurry and we'd have a real issue trying to blend the images together. So now we're gonna hop into the editing, and instead of explain every single step, I'm just gonna talk about the important things, because the concepts are really similar to things that I talked about in my 3 steps to stabilizing any hyperlapse and a hyper zoom. So I'm just gonna kind of cover a few of the things that are really specific to this. And if you need more information or you would like more information on it, I recommend checking those videos out, and I'll tell you when to use them. So the first thing I wanna do is I'm gonna go ahead and eliminate or cut out all of the photos of the Dunkin' Donuts. Basically where I see Kelly come in and then as soon as it's gone, that's step one. Then I'm gonna pre-comp it. And what I'm looking for next is I want to stabilize everything around Kelly's head, and that's where I want your eye to be looking at. So the first thing I want to do is I want to find something that she intersects, and right off the bat it's this yellow box. So I'm going to track the yellow box until it gets to Kelly's head. Boom, that's pretty much the whole entire process in a nutshell. I'm literally just going to track her head. The other thing that I think is important worth noting is when things intersect her and I can no longer see her, instead of trying to figure out a keyframe, I'm gonna actually delete the keyframes and have gaps. So you're not gonna see any gaps. Like look down here in the timeline and you can see there's a lot of gaps. And those are all just spots where I actually couldn't see Kelly. And instead of worrying about it, I'm just gonna do a first pass. And if I need to, which spoiler, I'm not gonna need to, but if I would need to, I would just go in and fix them if I needed to. So if you really want to understand that a little bit better, I really recommend checking out the video where I give you 3 secrets to stabilizing any hyperlapse. It goes through all of that in a lot more detail. Then the next step is, once we're all done and we're happy, everything's stabilized, we want to zoom in between the two layers, and it's really animating scale and position for one of the files and parenting them. And I talk about that in the hyper zoom tutorial. And to keep these tutorials as concise as possible, I recommend just watching that because it's the exact same steps that we're gonna use. All right, and so that is the process to editing it. And I think, you know, the whole thing is really just tracking the head. You know, it really is that straightforward. So if you're getting the hang of using the motion tracker in After Effects or Premiere or Final Cut or whatever, this is really not that difficult of a process. It's just time consuming to make sure, you know, it's center framed. The one thing I will say is that when I view it at a normal landscape, I like it full speed. But when it's kind of cropped into the Instagram, you know, 1080 by 1350 or like a vertical crop, I feel like it's a little bit too jarring and it doesn't work so well. I'm not 100% sure about that. It might just be personal preference, but that is it really. You know, I'm happy with it. I think it came out pretty fun. I like the little moonwalking. It looks like she's moonwalking across the street. But, you know, I'm excited to try this in the different seasons now that we got the snow one out of the way, and come back to it and see what it looks like. And that's it for this video. If you have any other questions about time-lapse and hyperlapse, and specifically how to blend them all together, please let me know. I think next week I'm gonna try a different format where I'm just gonna go to a location and just try to create different things instead of trying to recreate other people's work. And like always, if you're interested in time-lapse or hyperlapse photography, please consider subscribing to the YouTube channel. I do have a course where I teach all of these things and give you step-by-step instructions and offer mentorship. So if you're interested in that, check out the link below where you can learn more about the Hyperflow Masterclass. All right, well, happy shooting. I'm Scott, and I'll see you next time.